Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square of the Recitation of the Angelus with Pope Francis. And today is the third Sunday of Lent, March 20th, 2022. My name is Devin Watkins, and it is my pleasure to bring this live broadcast to you and the translation of the Pope's Angelus address and eventual appeals. From wherever you're joining us, whether via the Vatican media channels, the Vatican Audio Live Events app, or the Vatican Radio Vaticana app, or the Vatican News web portal, or Vatican News English YouTube channel, or our Facebook Live feed. We offer you a warm welcome, especially all of those joining through other broadcasters, including Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Shalom TV India, at Madarshan TV in India, and we also offer a warm welcome to the radio stations who are broadcasting with us, in particular Luminous Radio in India and Radio Maria England, as well as all the websites throughout the world picking up this broadcast. We welcome you all. The Angelus prayer, by the way, can be found by clicking on the Pray with the Pope on the Angelus tab on the Vatican News portal or our app. If you're joining us on television, you can see a large crowd gathered in St. Peter's Square. You'll also notice very colorful jackets and uniforms, because today there are several Italian associations and groups of volunteers who are celebrating their 30th anniversary. It's called the 30th anniversary of the 118. That's the emergency line here in India. If you have a problem, a medical problem, you call this group. And it's like the 911 in America. And so these groups, there's several of them, like the Red Cross, the ANPAS, and Misericordia. They are Mercy. They all come from Italy, and they've all joined together today and made a procession down the Via della Conciliazione toward St. Peter's Square, where they will be participating here with the Angelus, with Pope Francis, here in just a brief moment. And we see the curtains open, and Pope Francis comes to the window to greet the crowds.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buona domenica.
Dear brothers and sisters, happy Sunday.
Al cuore del cammino quaresimale. E il Vangelo della
liturgia. We are at the heart of our Lenten journey. And today, the Gospel begins by presenting Jesus, who comments on some news of his day. While people still remember the 18 people who died when a tower collapsed on them, they tell him about some Galileans whom Pilate had killed. And there's a question that seems to accompany these tragic events. Who is to blame for these terrible events? Perhaps those people were guiltier than others, and God punished them? These are questions that also come up today, when bad news weighs on us and we feel powerless before evil. We often ask ourselves, is it perhaps a punishment from God? Did He bring about a war or send us a pandemic to punish us for our sins? And why does the Lord not intervene? We must be careful. When evil oppresses us, we risk losing our clarity. And in order to find an easy answer to what we are unable to explain, we end up putting the blame on God. How often we attribute to him our own woes or misfortunes in the world. To him instead, who instead leaves us always free and never intervenes imposing, but only proposing. He who never uses violence and instead suffers for us and with us. Indeed, Jesus refuses and contests strongly the idea of blaming God for our evils. Those persons who were killed and those who died when the tower collapsed on them were not any more at fault than others, and they were not victims of a ruthless and vindictive God which does not exist. Evil can never come from God, because he does not deal with us according to our sins, but according to his mercy. This is the style of God. He can't deal with us in any other way. He always treats us with mercy. Instead of blaming God, Jesus says we need to look inside ourselves. It is sin that produces death. Our selfishness can tear apart relationships. Our wrong and violent choices can unleash evil. At this point, the Lord offers the true solution. What is it? Conversion. He says, unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. It is an urgent call, especially during this time of Lent. Let us welcome it with an open heart. Let us turn from evil. Let us renounce the sin that seduces us. Let us be open to the logic of the gospel. Because where love and fraternity reign, evil has no more power. But Jesus knows that conversion is not easy, that so many times we make the same mistakes and the same sins that we can become discouraged, and sometimes our commitment to do good can seem useless in a world where evil seems to rule. So after his appeal, he encourages us with a parable that tells of the patience God has toward us. The patience God has toward us. He offers the consoling image of a fig tree that does not bear fruit during the accorded season, but it is not cut down. He gives it more time, another possibility. I like to think about a nice name for God would be a God of another possibility. There's always another possibility, another chance. Always. That is his mercy. This is how the Lord works with us. He does not cut us out of his love. He does not lose heart or tire of giving us tenderness and his trust again.
Dio crede in noi.
Brothers and sisters, God believes in us. He trusts us and accompanies us with patience, the patience of God. He does not get discouraged, but always instills hope in us. God is Father and looks after you as a father. As the best of fathers, he does not look at the achievements you have not yet reached, but the fruits that you can yet bear. He does not keep track of your shortcomings, but encourages your potential. He does not dwell on your past, but confidently bets on your future. Because God is always near to us. The style of God is, we should never forget it, is always closeness. He is close, like mercy and tenderness. That is how God accompanies us, a God of mercy and tenderness. So let us ask the Blessed Virgin Mary to fill us with hope and courage and kindle in us the desire for conversion.
et concepit Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedicto fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedicto fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedicto fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Ut digni efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo nunciante Christi Fili Tui, incarnazione coniobimus, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionem gloriam perducamur. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domine benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle, non si arresta purtroppo la violenta aggressione contro l'Ucraina, un massacro insensato, dove ogni giorno si ripetono scempi e atrocità. Non c'è giustificazione per questo. Supplico tutti gli attori della comunità internazionale perché si impegnino davvero nel far cessare questa guerra.
The war, aggression against Ukraine has not ceased and continues. Violent acts of aggression occur each day. There is no justification for this. I appeal to the world to put an end to this. There are bombs on civilians and on elderly people and pregnant mothers. I went to visit the young children who are here in Rome, who've been wounded in the war. Young, innocent children, one had an amputated arm, one with a wound to the head. I think about the millions of Ukrainian refugees who have to leave everything behind, and those do not even have the possibility to leave. Many grandparents and grandchildren who are separated from their families. So many who are dying under the bombs, and those who are unable to find refuge even under bunkers. All of this is dishuman and sacrilegious, because it goes against the sacredness of human life. Above all, it is against the human life, innocent human life, which should be respected and not harmed, and should come before any strategy. It is a cruelty, one that is sacrilegious and dishuman, inhuman. Let us pray for a second for those who are suffering. we pray with Pope Francis for those who are suffering in Ukraine. It consoles me to know that the people who have stayed under the bombing, there is no lack to the solidarity and the closeness of their pastors who are experiencing and showing their fraternity and closeness. And I spoke to several of them recently, and they are close to to their people. Thank you, brothers and sisters, for your help and concrete assistance to your offering to many desperate people. I also think about the Apostolic Nuncio, who was just made Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Visualdas Kubokas, who since the beginning of the war has remained at Kiev with his collaborators, and who brings my closeness to the suffering Ukrainian people. Let us be close to this people, suffering, battered people. Let us embrace them with our prayer and concrete assistance. And please, let us never become used to violence and war. Let us not tire. Let us not tire of welcoming generously as we are, even in not only in the emergency moment that is now, but in the weeks to come, those who are fleeing. We know that right in this moment, we all give everything we have to welcome people who are fleeing. But then as time goes on, we gradually forget these women, children, who with time, without work, left, separated from their husbands, will be sought out by the vultures of society. Let us protect them, please. I invite every community of every faithful person to join me on Friday, March 25th, consecrate Russia and Ukraine to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, so that she, the Mother of Peace, will obtain peace for the world. I greet all of you, Romans and pilgrims who have come from Italy and various countries, especially the faithful of Madrid. And the international group of Agora, the peoples of the earth, and the doctors and medics of the 118 Association.
The charismatic
renewal, Catholic charismatic renewal movement, which is the only one that is officially recognized, not other ones. Also, the little choir of Antoniano of Bologna,
di Fornovo San Giovanni. Il coro
and the choir of San Vincenzo Grossi,
I ragazzi della professione di fede di Angera,
children of the
Sesto Calende Eternate,
various catechism classes,
il pellegrinaggio della diocesi di Asti,
and the a pilgrimage from the diocese of Asti,
di Venezia e
and the faithful from Venice and Sassari. To all of you, I wish you a happy Sunday, and please do not forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch, and goodbye. And with that, Pope Francis wraps up his Angelus address and prayer here in St. Peter's Square. We thank you all for joining us. And we hear the bells of St. Peter's. We close this live broadcast of the Noonday Angelus. Please visit our Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus and other Vatican and world news. On behalf of Vatican Media, I'm Devin Watkins, and I thank all of the technicians who made this broadcast possible and to all of you for joining us. A blessed Sunday to you all. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.